I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything.
Hey guys, it's Gareth from Smash Pew Pew Pew, and welcome to week 3 of season 6 of the GPC. This week I'm facing off against Turbo, coach of the Phoenix Midnights. He's had a team change, as you can see, challenges there. Quickly run over the team, somewhat defensive Arcanine with the Rizpideth. This is a complete stop to both both Lucario and Kieran Black, that's the other thing. With the Sugar Berry, it can do pretty much nothing to me unless it's got something like Draco. But I still don't get to it carried, I believe, so... So it shouldn't be too bad. That's what it's there for. Flablitz is good coverage against the team, and extreme speed is always nice to have. Then I have Choice Scarf Sirena. This is a sort of emergency check to Lucario. High Jump Kick is at Noko after Rocks, I believe. It's a roll to Oko either way. With Queenly Majesty, I am immune to all forms of priority, so even if he is an SD set, I can still beat it. Chop Kick and High Jump Kick for coverage, U-turn and Rapid Spin. Kind of basics, really. Then we have an offensive Gardevoir. He has no switch-ins to a Hyper Voice at all. Shadow Ball is just there for coverage against his Mew and his Delmies. Aside from that, it's just spam Hyper Voice all day, which is why I've got Carmine. At plus one, I basically Oko everything, and sub up allows me to basically get a free sub and force something like a Zucario, say, to Bullet Punch. Ice Glass is Hydreigon, so I can 2-hit KO with Dark Pulse on his Mew. I was running Dragon Fang initially, but either way, Ice Glass's boost is good. U-turn and just this coverage beats the team. U-turn's useful and Tailwind is good to basically allow the Gardevoir to get through. I initially had Agility, Baton Pass, Puzzle, but that didn't happen. Then we have an Assault Vest Gigalith with 8400 Special Defense. This is my blanket check to Zergatree. I can basically take no damage from Inoko with Earthquake. Standard stuff, really. Even without the AV, I don't get to hit KO'd, but with the AV, I can also take hits from his Mew if it's specially offensive, so that's what it's there for. Stealth Rocks is going to be useless on this set unless I get knocked off. I have no idea why I'm still running Rocks in Assault Vest, but I honestly don't need any of the moves, so I'm not going to change it. Then we have Expert Belt Toxicroak, I guess in case I get knocked off by his Croak. Expert Belt Toxicroak so that at plus 2 I can kill something with Vacuum Wave. I forget what it was. Oh, it was his Kieran Black after Rocks. If I was an Expert Belt, I couldn't have done that. So yeah, we'll see how this goes. That was a faster analysis than usual. It's about pretty much what I expected. I'm surprised to actually see the Delmise, but honestly I'm not too worried about it. He's gone for a very offensive setup, as have I. I think leading Sirena is probably my safest bet, as I can maybe catch something off guard, and if not, just U-turn. He also has a Gorbis in the back, which I knew he wouldn't bring because of Vaporeon, so I'm guessing this will have Fusion Bolt for it, and this is basically a Vaporeon nuke, so... He didn't bring Croak, that was the one thing that I was scared of. I would have expected Croak over Houndoom, but I'll take that any day of the week. So his added removal is probably going to be Delmise this week. So... If I do get my Rocks up, I basically have a free switch into something to punish it. Like my Hydreigon, for example. Or even Arcanine, because can't really do much to Arcanine. Starts off with Mew. That's kind of what I expected, to be honest, as this is probably his rocker. Either way, I think clicking U-turn is my play, and we can scout to see if this is potentially scarfed. I think either way I can live any one hit. But I think this does reveal that I'm scarfed, or at least speedy. But I'm going to click U-turn anyway. It does, I think it was 30% to standard specially defensive Mew. So, well, this will allow me to scout to see if it is defensive or specially defensive. Let's get this lined up. To 39%. Yeah, that's looking like specially defensive to me. That was either specially defensive mineral or 252. Yeah, specially defensive mineral. He's probably just going to set up his rocks here. So I'm probably just going to go out into Hydreigon. As he goes for Aura Sphere, that still does nothing. Good to know. Dark Pulse is a 2-hit KO on specially defensive Mew, so he definitely can't start stalling me out, but what would be his switch into a Dark Pulse at this point? Maybe Lucario, but that is a very, very ballsy play to make this early. I honestly think it's worth me taking the 40%, because this isn't going to be treeing hits from very much aside from maybe the Houndoom. Which I do have Serena for, and Toxicroak, so I'm not too worried. I do think clicking Dark Pulse is my play, although it does give him basically a free switch into Lucario. I'm going to click Draco, as he doesn't switch out, good to know. As he clicks Roost, scouting for what I was doing. Okay, that's fair enough. Probably expecting me to be scarfed by that damage, as I don't reveal much. Definitely not knife hold, definitely not specs. As now, I'm not sure what I want to free switch into, to be honest. He's either setting up his rocks. I'm guessing he's got defog as well. Unless he's probably running rapid spin down, as I said that earlier, didn't I? I don't know what I want to bring on this. I guess I can bring in Serena again and click U-turn. Just start stalling it out of roosts. I think that's a fair enough choice, as he does have Toxic. That's the one thing I didn't want to do, is bring Gardevoir in on Toxic. Again, just going to click U-turn. It's my safest play. Nothing really wants to switch in on it, except for maybe Lucario, so I'm fine with this. As he's probably going to click Roost, or I would if I was him at least. He does do that, and I am 100% guessing he has only Aura Sphere as his attacking move, so I'm going to click Sub, as he'll probably go for the Toxic. Getting this thing behind a sub is huge, because nothing really wants to take a hit from this, so it's going to be very useful indeed. As I do get up the sub, does he go for the Toxic? Yes, he does. Pretty much what I expected from his Mew, and I can just click Hyper Voice to my heart's content, as this can't break my sub, and nothing really wants to take two Hyper Voices except for this, but this does mean that I can... What does he have to bring in? Yeah, I'm just going to kill this off. I should have maybe gone for the Shadow Ball, as it probably would have killed from that point, but either way, I'm not revealing all my coverage is at this point. I have just revealed so far that I can essentially kill his Mew. I don't think this gets Shadow Sneak, but I just want to make sure. Oh my eyes. No, it doesn't. As I can just kill this off. That's dead. What's his bring into this? If he brings in his Lucario, that means it's got Bullet Punch. If he brings in this, it's scarfed. I'm just gonna have to go out into Arcanine at this point. I don't see what he'd be other than Bullet Punch or potentially scarfed, so I'm not gonna risk my Gardevoir at this point. I need it, because it does so much to this guy's team. I'm expecting Zergatry to be scarfed this game, but we'll see. The fact that he doesn't have seismic toss on his Mew is huge for me. That was the one thing that could have potentially broken this sub, so it's good to know that he doesn't have it. He's only got Aura Sphere, presumably for Hydreigon. I'm not sure what else that would hit that would otherwise switch in on Mew, but... at this point, with the damage that Mew's had to it done, if I get Rocks up, which I won't because, I mean... okay, let's calc this. I think that's banded damage. Where's Arcanine? Sif from Lucario. Shadow usage. Yeah, he didn't show Life Orb, so that's a jolly band. Which means he's probably switching out. If I had to hazard a guess, probably into Mew. So I'm just going to go straight out into Gardevoir. Goes out into Houndoom. That's bad. I need to calc this. I think I can take any one hit, but I don't want to risk doing so. Senya against Houndoom. If I can't kill, I'm not staying in. I don't think I'm going to anyway, but... yeah, Fire Blast doesn't do too much to me. And, Hyper Voice does do a lot of damage, but I don't want to keep this in at all. Can Hydreigon take two? No. I think Gigalith can switch in pretty safely. Either way. I didn't expect him to bring this in, but I'm guessing he's Flash Fire. As I just go for the Fire Blast and I do chew that, please don't burn. Thank God. This does reveal what my set is, I think, so... I don't think he's running knockoff this week, which is rather unfortunate, but... I think I can just click... Stone Edge does everything... does a lot to everything except for Lucario. I'd rather Mew switch in than Lucario, so I'm just going to click Earthquake. Because that still does quite a bit of damage, to be fair. I need to keep this healthy. I really want to find out what his last move is. Because if his last move is Stealth Rocks, then it's just set up fodder for Toxicroak. And if I get to plus one, or even plus two, if I get to plus four, sorry, on Toxicroak, I win. So that's something to keep in mind. I want to say I can probably bring in Arcanine safely, but I don't really want to switch this out. He's probably going to click Toxic. I'm going to go out into Serena. So he just goes for Roost. Okay. I think my safest play is to go out into Toxicroak at this point, because... his last remove has to be Rocks. It's going to be Rocks or Will-O-Wisp. And either way, he's probably going to click Toxic. I'm just going to go out into Toxicroak. I don't see him having two attacking moves. I'm clicking Nasty Plot. If he does have Psychic, I die. If he doesn't have Psychic, I get a free Nasty Plot up. Which is huge. He probably doesn't know if this is going to be special, so I wouldn't be surprised if he goes out into something like Kyurem. I do get the Nasty Plot off, as he does a Psychic. Okay, that's good. Good to know. I know it's full moveset now, which means I can get... I can basically get a free switch into Mega Gardevoir. As I can click sub, nothing wants to switch in on this as ever, so... it's a shame that I lost it, that's sort of like a contingency for Houndoom gone. But, at least now I know that this thing's full moveset, and I know that it doesn't have Stealth Rocks, so it doesn't have Rocks this week. so I don't need to worry about spinning on Serena. I banked on something that I shouldn't have banked on, maybe, but Toxicroak wasn't my biggest win con this game. It was definitely Mega Gardevoir, so I'm not too worried about it. I can just set up a free sub here. And if he goes into something as a sack... Okay, Houndoom comes in. I should have maybe clicked Carmine there. I was going to cancel it at the last moment, but... let's go back to Gardevoir. I think I do die to Fire Blast from here. Yeah, I do. I just have to go into Gigalith, really. Or... Yeah, I have to go into Gigalith at this point. I can chew any one hit this has, so I'm not worried. As he does get a crit. Rather unfortunate, but I'm not worried at all. Because this thing just... He's probably just going to sack this, to be honest. So... Would he go for an energy ball if he's running it? I'm just going to click Stone Edge. As he does sack this off, as he does go for the Dark Pulse, that's fine. This still has enough HP to take an energy ball from a Zekatri, so I'm not worried. It's still going to fulfill its purpose. The only thing that can kill this, I think, is Lucario at this point, so I'm really not worried. If he brings in his Lucario, I know for a fact that it's banded. So that's good knowledge to have, and I think my best play at that point is just to sack something. Neither of us are in a particularly good position because we both have things that pressure the other one's team massively. I'm just hoping that when he goes to Calc for Zekatri that he forgets Sandstorm, because somebody else did that against me once and it cost them their Zekatri. So it's good knowledge to have. Let's put Gigalith on there. That's not the same Gigalith then, I don't think, no. I don't know why that one's still saved on, but that's from that game that I was referring to. And Zerk. Oh, you Tail Glow. Yeah, Energy Ball only is up to 38%. So I'm not threatened at all by this. And Earthquake Arcos, of course, because that's what it's EV'd to do. It does go out into Lucario, which is good to know. As I'm tempted to say, he's probably going to go for the Steel move. But either way, Arcanine, even if I do die to this, I'm more than fine letting it go. Unless his Kyurem Black is curved. But either way, I think I have to sack something else off. I need this to take a hit from Zerkatree. What does Hydreigon do? It knocks down the Mew, of course. I think going out into Hydreigon is my best play. But I'm not going to risk it. I have to go into Arcanine. He's going to click Close Combat either way. But it's a play that I had to make. As now I do get a free switch into Mega Gardevoir, as I know this is Choice Banded. Just by the damage. And I think I just click Hyper Voice at this point. Nothing wants to come in on this. And if he loses his Lucario now, I think I just win. So I'm just going to click Hyper Voice. That's a jolly banded Lucario, I know that. I can definitely take a close combat from there, but probably not nicely. I outspeed anyway, what am I on about? As I can kill with his defenses lowered, I'm like 90% sure. Showdown usage, yeah. I don't even have to have the minus one to kill it. As basically anything he brings in just dies, so. Shoutouts to Mega Gardevoir, boys. I just want to see if he is Choice Banned. I know there's Jolly Banned already, pretty much, from that damage. What's Jolly? Bullet Punch against Gigalith. How much does it do? There's a chance I can live it, which is hilarious. He's basically choosing something to die right now. I need to check again how much... Again, I outspeed, but I just want to know for future reference how much it does. I can switch in on it. Which is good to know. He has to save this. He absolutely has to save this. He's choosing something to sack. I think Zergatree can maybe take one and then die, but... Let's see. Oh, Zergatree's not taking one. Unless I get an absolute minimum roll, it's not taking one with the Sandstorm damage. And his Mew, which is Spadef, is going to get 2 KO'd, so... Something's dying. And he knows it. With the contingency of Scarfed Serena, I am really looking in a good spot right now. As he does choose to sack this off, I'm more than happy with that. As whatever he brings in, either Zergatree or Kieran back, is 100% Scarfed. If he brings in his Mew, this is Scarfed. No doubt in my mind, this is Scarfed. I need to see how much Hydreigon takes from Zergatree. I can't take two. And I don't think I outspeed one. I definitely outspeed it after, though. I think just going out into Hydreigon is my play. His reveals to be Zed Rain Dance. Okay. Didn't expect that. I think I could have just outsped and killed that, but that's fine. So I think I'm just going to click Draco. Has he run Signal Beam? That's interesting. And I completely forgot about Beast Boost being a thing, but... I want to say I can take any one hit with this thing. The fact that he stayed in is huge. I did not expect him to be that ballsy. As I can take... No, I can't take one. I think that's game. Scarf. Bluff. OP. He bluffed the fuck out of me though. And I'm upset. This game was mine to win. I should have stayed in. I shouldn't have risked it. Hidden Power Water Rain Dance OP. I probably could have lived if I just switched into this. Oh, that's really frustrating. I completely forgot that this was his Zed move user, to be honest. Either way, the fact that he stayed in on Mega Gardevoir without him being scarfed and just brought it in like that, without showing a scarf prior, was what sort of tipped me off to it. I'm guessing he probably had Scarf Cure and Black in the back. But... yeah, that's really annoying. I honestly thought I had that one in the bag from the moment that I got the kill on Lucario. Yes, I probably should have stayed in, but I didn't want to lose my Gardevoir at that point. Let's have a quick look again. Gardevoir. In Zergatree. I had a massive chance to kill with the Sandstorm being up. That's really frustrating. I shouldn't have lost Toxicroak early either, but I was honestly thought his Mew wouldn't have Psychic. If I still had Toxicroak, I could have probably killed this off through one means or another. Anyway, that's it. It's me going 0-3 with what, minus 10 differential now. It's not looking great, even though I don't think I've played particularly poorly. I just think in this instance he just outplayed the hell out of me in that one turn. So, guess I can thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.